In this episode, I'll be talking about how to sell more courses with successful joint ventures.
Welcome to the Online Course Coach Podcast, brought to you by TrueFocusMedia.com. Whether you're a beginner or expert, this is the podcast for the latest in online course creation tips, news, interviews, and ideas. And here's your coach, Jeff Long.
Welcome back to another episode of the Online Course Coach Podcast, where we take an authentic look at creating online courses. We want to help people. We want to teach people. And so today we want to talk about how to even more effectively teach people outside of your audience that you can bring in, you can teach, and you can help more people. But before we do that, I want to talk about two things. The first thing is, there have been some people that have written in iTunes reviews. I just want to read those really quickly and give them a shout out and say thank you. First one is Dr. Eugene Matthews. He said, "Hey Jeff, I've been listening to your podcast for a couple of months now and find it refreshingly informational. I'm a full-time professor at a university and already develop and teach courses online for my institution. After listening to your podcast, whether solo or with your guests like Carrie Dills, or Rebecca Gill, I've gotten interested in creating my own courses. So thank you for the inspiration as well as the information. I'll keep you posted on my progress." I would definitely love to hear how that's coming, Dr. Matthews, how your personal courses are coming along. I think that's fantastic to take your all your wisdom, your experience, and help people maybe outside of your institution. We'll see how that goes. And then secondly, author David Freeman wrote this in with a 5-star review. He said, "Currently, my daily commute is spent learning the logistics of online course creation. Jeff is an articulate, engaging coach who provides valuable, actionable information while respecting my intelligence and my time." And David, I really appreciate that. That means a lot. So thank you both for that, those 5-star reviews and for those kind words. I mean, I know to take a minute out of your time and write that, hey, it takes a couple minutes to go there, to think, to do it. So that means a lot. And David and I have had some conversations through Twitter, actually, about some different things. So that's been a lot of fun. So if you want to leave a rating and review, that helps more people get access to this show. You can go to onlinecoursecoach.com/iTunes, and you can leave a review. Or you can go to onlinecoursecoach.com/reviews and leave one there as well. Now, if you're on a different device, a different, you know, Google or Spotify or whatever, I would still love a review. But I just know that currently iTunes is the biggest podcast distributor or whatever you want to call it. And so that's where a lot of people leave their review. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is something I'm really excited about, because just last week, I had 4 people reach out to me and ask for group coaching. And, you know, when 4 people or, you know, when several people reach out saying the same thing, your ears perk up. My friend and mentor, Dan Miller, says if 2 or 3 people ask for the same product, he creates it. And he has an audience of thousands. All right. So when I had 4 people say, "Hey, would you consider doing group coaching?" I thought now would be the time to put that together. It's been on my radar, something I've been wanting to do, but this gave me the extra motivation to make that available because I want to help more people. So since many of you know that my goal is to help 5 million people in 5 years, which is overwhelming, right? I made that goal because honestly, I knew it was overwhelming, but I also knew I couldn't do it myself. And that's really why I have the motto that I say at the end of every podcast, which is, you know, my goal is to help you, to teach many, to impact millions, because that's how we're going to get to that 5 million mark. Now, I know a lot of you have felt overwhelmed with your course. You felt stuck. Maybe you haven't even created it yet because it is overwhelming. You have felt stuck. Maybe you don't know how to market it. Maybe you already have a course, but you know the marketing just isn't in place. And I also know that many of you learn better when you're in a group that can hold you accountable and where you personally can ask questions to me and others in the group. And so that's why I'm creating this Course Accelerator Coaching Group. Now, it's a 6-week program that's starting September 18th. We meet every Tuesday And I'm limiting this to up to 10 people. So this is not going to be a big group. I really want it small and focused so we can help each other succeed. Now, here are some reasons why you might want to consider the Course Accelerator Coaching Group. First of all, you not only get personal access to me, but you also have direct access to the group of motivated course creators. So you can ask questions throughout the process, get feedback, and go further much faster. Now, I'll be recording each session on video, so you can access it during the 6 weeks. So if you need a refresher, if you need to review something, you can. I'll also have it available after the 6 weeks. So you get access to that long term, which will be very, very helpful. I'll be creating a private Facebook group where we can just interact together, ask questions, get feedback, you know, get other people's eyes on it. And that will be extremely helpful. And then we'll be going through my proven plan to help you create your online course, even if you're not a techie. All right. So if you're not technical, if you don't want to, you know, learn how to code and all that, we're not going to be diving in deep. We're going to be going effective and simple and effective, not complex, full of jargon, full of expensive software, confusing stuff and, you know, equipment or whatever. We're going to keep it simple. And then one of the things I think will be extremely helpful is everybody will walk out with a customized marketing plan to grow your audience, build your influence, and increase sales, even if you're just starting out, because that is one of the hardest things is, you know, you probably have an expertise and that's where you can create the course. But if you don't have an audience or influence, then selling your course is going to be a lot harder. So I'll be presenting many effective marketing strategies and then we'll dial that down to just the one or two that you think will be the best for you and you can start implementing that. Now, I will say this, you know, those are just some of the things that this coaching group will contain. There's a lot of other cool stuff we'll be doing. If you're not able or willing to put in the work during these sessions or throughout the week, it's probably not a good fit. You know, if you're like, I'll just sit in the sessions and then in, you know, 6 months or a year or 5 years or 10 years or never, I'll get to this. I want motivated course creators that are like, hey, Jeff, I've been wanting to do this. This is going to give me a kick in the seat, motivation to get me up and creating my course and putting this out there so I can help more people. That's who I want in this group. Now, it doesn't matter if you have no audience, no course, no nothing. That's fine. Or maybe some of you have a course, but it's not optimized. It's not where you want it to be. Maybe it's not even complete. Or, you know, maybe you don't even have an audience, or maybe you do have an audience, but no course. Whatever that mix is, don't feel intimidated. All right. If you go to the website, you can go to onlinecoursecoach.com/group coaching. You can learn more and fill out an application. I'm actually not taking a payment right now because I want people to fill out the application because I want it to be a good mix of people in the group. You know, some will be brand new, some will be a little more established, some will have influence and an audience and an email list, some won't, and that's fine. We're all going to help each other. It's that phrase, a rising tide lifts all ships, right? We're going to lift each other up through encouragement, through help. We're going to motivate each other, and we're going to get this done. So again, go to onlinecoursecoach.com/group coaching to see if this is a good fit for you. Fill out the application. We start September 18th. I'll be going through those applications. And if I select you, then we'll be going through the payment and the details and the setup and all that good stuff. There are some pricing packages. So you can choose the basic one, or if you want the upgraded one with some really cool bonuses, then that might be a good fit for you. And then just to let you know, I've already reached out to a couple people that have been interacting with me. And I already have maybe almost half of the spots filled. I have to go back and look, but I know I had at least four, maybe even more at this point, people reach out and say, hey, Jeff, I'm interested. I'm filling out the application. So, you know, there's not many spots left. So go to onlinecoursecoach.com/group coaching to fill out that application. All right, let's talk today about how to sell more courses with successful joint ventures. And honestly, joint ventures and partnerships and selling for other people, it can kind of have some ugly connotations. In fact, I've kind of stayed away from this in some ways because, you know, you get those emails, at least, you know, maybe you're on, you know, several people's email lists and they're all promoting the same thing, right? It kind of gets old, especially when they're saying the exact same thing. So maybe you get a invite to a webinar and they barely give you any content, but a long sales pitch. Or maybe it's a three-part video series that, you know, 100 people are promoting. And so you're just getting bombarded with emails. You know, it can feel ugly. It can feel gross, you know? But on the flip side, one of my first courses really got its success because of a joint venture. You know, I've told this story before, but it's my first course started out as a failure. I didn't do my research. I didn't have a pre-sales survey. I didn't have a beta launch. I didn't have a test group. I just went into my bat cave. I created some courses. And then when I emerged, I didn't have anybody waiting for that. And I was disappointed, to say the least. I was depressed. I was pretty down. But thankfully, I happened to be on a webinar, listening to a webinar, not hosting it. I happened to be listening to a webinar with some guys I've been following for a long time, and they were talking about some different things, and I offered to partner with them. I said, hey, I actually have a course exactly what you're talking about. You know, would it help the audience? And they reached out to me. We had a deal, and it worked out really, really well. And it didn't work out well just for me or the people I was partnering with. It really worked out well for the people taking the course. And that's what I want to talk about today. We're going to talk about the bad, the good, and then how to get started if you think it's a good fit. So let's talk about the bad. Or let me say this first. Even if you don't have a course, I want you to at least listen to this podcast. I want you to consider the options and the opportunities. And then when you do have a course, that's when you can implement this and get this up and running. So let's talk about the bad first and why you might have a bad taste in your mouth. I've talked about this just a few minutes ago, but you kind of feel gross, you know, when there's this big joint venture and everyone sends out the same email template, everyone gets bombarded with emails on the same book or course or this or that, whatever it is, we all get them. In fact, I've really unsubscribed from a lot of people because I'm kind of sick of getting, you know, all the same emails. And so I am subscribed to a few people and I don't mind getting their emails because it's good content. I trust and respect them. You know, I know that maybe I've taken their course before or I've met them or whatever it is. So I don't want to make this blanket statement of, hey, this is always bad, because it's definitely not. And then do you ever kind of feel gross when maybe you've tried it out and you feel kind of gross sending out emails promoting someone else's course or product or whatever, because you might feel like you're taking advantage of your audience to make a quick buck? That's when it's bad, right? When you kind of feel gross, when you kind of feel weird. Now, all that to say, I've talked with a lot of people, a lot of you listeners, a lot of you have written in, we've had cool conversations, I've spoken at conferences and events, and one thing I've noticed is most people don't like selling. So I really want to talk about why that is and how you can get over that, because I feel like with this podcast, like with this coaching group I just promoted, if I was only in it to make a quick buck, I would be doing you all a disservice, right? But I know, I believe that you know, whoever is in the group will get amazing value, help. They will be able to just get unstuck, right? As I'm stuck trying to think of how to say unstuck. But I know that there's value in that. And so whenever I'm talking to somebody and selling a product, a service, a course, whatever that is, I have to believe that whatever price they're going to pay is less than the value that they're going to get. And when that happens, I feel great, you know, but it's when I feel like, oh, you know, if you pay, you know, X amount of dollars, you might get it back in a couple years, then I start to feel bad. And I start to feel like, oh, I don't know if I should do this or I can do this. And so one of the ways that I actually like selling is because I view it as serving other people. You know, I think I was in junior high and I went to this small private school and we had to raise funds to help, you know, some needy people be able to go to this school. And so there was this fundraiser, and me and a friend just went knocking door to door on complete strangers' houses asking for donations. Now, that might put you, you know, you might break out in cold sweats if you think about that yourself, but I was only able to do that because I truly believe that, hey, I was helping other people have a good education. So I've always had different sales jobs. I've done sales. I've promoted things, but it's always been in that mindset of how can I make this a win for everybody, not just me. So if you're thinking, Jeff, okay, I haven't sold many of my courses, and this whole joint venture thing, I feel kind of weird because I don't like to sell things. Well, you need to ask yourself if you actually believe that your course helps people, right? Because if it doesn't, then yeah, you shouldn't sell. But if you think that your course conveys some material, it helps the learner get from point A to Z, or maybe just A to B, then you owe it to them. It's your responsibility. I think it's your duty for you to sell your online course, and you should not apologize about that. I've talked a lot about pricing in the past. So if you go to onlinecoursecoach.com/course pricing, I talk about some course pricing strategies. And one of those is pricing tiers. I think pricing tiers are extremely helpful because that way you let the student, the learner, the customer, whatever you want to call them, they get to decide what's most valuable to them. Maybe it's only price and they just want the cheapest thing. Maybe it's value and they want the most access to you or the most bonuses or the most whatever. They want to pay the most money because they want the maximum result, right? Or maybe it's just somewhere in between. So that's where you really have to first believe that your course helps people, not apologize. And then if you do feel strange about it, you know, it's, like I said, pricing tiers is a win-win because then the student gets to pick what's important to them. Now, let's talk about why you would want to consider using joint ventures, and then we'll talk about how to get started. So first, if you don't have a course or a product, then you really can't do joint ventures, right? So get off the sidelines and create your course. Now, if you do have an email list or social media following or influence or whatever that might be, you could find other people that have great products, courses, books, whatever, and you could promote those. So don't think that you have to have a course. If you have an audience and an influence, then you can find other people with valuable, helpful content. And then, like I said, don't be shy about the value you provide and the expertise that you have. Even if you're just starting out, you might think, oh, I've only been doing this for a year, 2 years, whatever. Think about that person that's a couple steps behind you. You know, maybe this last year you've been researching and trying to get into a certain topic or field or hobby. Well, think about the person that just started yesterday. You know, they are just starting out. You are several steps down the road, and you can have that fresh perspective of what it feels like to be overwhelmed or intimidated by all the stuff out there. You know, if you're shy about the value you provide, here's an activity that I think would be very helpful, because this is what I just did recently. So take a few minutes to write out all the things that you're good at. And this is not a boastful, hey, look at me, I'm awesome. This is to really think like, wow, you're actually probably more talented than you think you are. So think about, are you good with people? Are you good with technology or business? Maybe you're good with animals or numbers or art or language. You know, there's a lot of different things you can be good at. So think about what those are. Do you have schooling in a certain area, certifications, proven results, or other things that set you apart? Write down as many skills as you can think of. And so let's say you are an art teacher. Don't just say, I'm good at art. You know, is it a specific type of art? Maybe it's pencil drawings or watercolor, or I better not go on because I'm not good at art. And I would quickly show you that I'm not good at art. So I'll end it right there. But think about all the different aspects of your job, of your life, of your skills that you have, and write down as many of those skills as you can think of. And then revisit this for a few days and add to the list and see that you have more value than you might think. You know, like I said, I just did this recently and I quickly came up with almost 70 things, you know, 70 things that I feel like I'm better than most people. Again, not in a boastful way, just, hey, I'm blessed to be good in these areas. Now, I'm sure I could have written 300 things that I'm not good at, all right, probably in like 2 minutes. But the key is, you're better than you probably think you are, especially if you're shy or you're intimidated. So don't be afraid to make that list, and you can revisit it to build your confidence. Now, once you have a good course, once you have a good foundation, so I would recommend having several, many, whatever students in your course already before you approach somebody for this type of partnership. Excuse me. Because, you know, if you say, hey, I'm about to launch this course, you want to promote it, it's kind of awkward because they might not know if it's a good course. All right. But don't be afraid to ask, even if you feel intimidated. Now, the key is to find audiences with similar interests, especially if they're underserved. So, you know, if you have a course on how to teach English to, you know, a certain other language, you know, Spanish, French, German, whatever, maybe you could find travel agents to partner with, and so they would sell your course. It's a natural fit, you know? So if you're going to Spain, you probably want to learn the language. Here's an excellent online course that you can take with you as you go. So find similar interests, similar audiences. Even if you think you're a competitor, you know, find out how you're not a competitor. Find out how your course can serve that person's audience and talk to them about this. You know, ideally, you don't want to find five affiliate partners in the same industry who share the same audience. You know, isn't that annoying? Like I talked about before, when you're getting bombarded with emails about the same course, about the same promo, and from different people. You know, it's pretty annoying. It's pretty annoying. And then find ways to serve that person's audience. So maybe it's courses, maybe it's coaching or consulting, maybe it's group training or done for you services, or, you know, it doesn't just have to be courses, but figure out a way where you can maximize, you can leverage the amount that you're serving that person's audience, especially if you have a smaller audience. I've seen it. I've seen people just explode their business because they serve an influencer well. And that influencer says, oh, wow, hey, have you seen, you know, this person's course or this person's material? And the influencer will really kind of explode that person's business in a good way. And then also look for win-win-win. So everyone feels awesome and not disgusting. All right. So the audience needs to win. The other person that you're doing this joint venture with needs to win. And you need to win. And if you're not going to win, then I don't know that it's worth it. Now, you could say, hey, I might not make a lot of money, but I might increase my influence. Okay, that's fine. You know, you have to determine what a win is for you, but make sure that there is a benefit there for you. All right, let's talk about how to get started. So how do you find these people you might want to do joint ventures with? When I say joint ventures, this could also be called, you know, an affiliate program, anything like that. So you could go to podcasts, you could find YouTube creators, you could find authors, influencers, social media leaders, Facebook group owners, LinkedIn groups, meetups, conferences, anywhere, really, there is a trusted leader that could benefit from your courses and their audience could benefit too. Again, you owe it to them to help people out by offering your course. And if you have that mentality of, hey, I just want to help you, I think your audience could really benefit from this material, it's going to shine through. And that's an easier yes than a, hey, buy my stuff, right? So if you come at it with serving them, it's going to be an easier yes all around. And then one of the questions I get a lot is, you know, how do you structure that? Do you have a complicated contract in place? Do you, you know, have to both go to a lawyer? Hey, you can. I'm not a lawyer, so I'm not going to tell you yes or no. Generally, it's kind of just an agreement, because the good thing is with course sales, you can track them. Super simple, right? You know, so you can just go to your website or your software, print out a sheet that tells you how many sales you had in this period of time, or maybe they have a specific link that they give and you can track that. So make sure that whatever you're doing, it's very trackable, it's very transparent, because there's no worse thing than, you know, at the end of this promotion, that you have no idea how many courses they sold. All right. A typical price split is negotiable, but 50-50 is common in many industries. So you want it high enough where they get the value. Don't just come and say, hey, you could get, you know, 3%. Well, I mean, unless, you know, they have an audience of a couple million or billion people, that's not going to move the dial at all. So again, 50-50 is pretty common. Anything's negotiable, but you want to make it where it's a benefit to them. All right. Have a good course. You have a track record of success. You've identified somebody to partner with or do a joint venture. And when I say partner or joint venture, I'm not talking about you start an LLC together and you do this formal thing. No, you're just asking them to, you know, promote your course or whatever. Well, what do you do then? What I do for a lot of my clients and students and myself and different things is we set up an affiliate program directly on their website. Now, there's different WordPress plugins you can use. There's different software you can use. I've, you know, tested some and have read a lot of reviews. And if you're on the WordPress side, there are several really good ones. So do some research. The one I started to use is Affiliate WP, has a lot of good features, and I'm really happy with it. But like I said, there are other plugins or other services that run and manage this just for you. And so what you'll do is you'll set that up. You'll send a link to somebody and they can sign up to be your an affiliate. And then you can kind of tag them or you know, put what course or courses they're able to promote. So if you go to onlinecoursecoach.com/affiliate, you can sign up or you can look. And I actually have to approve people that want to be an affiliate because I want to make sure it's a good fit for everybody. So for instance, if you have an audience and one of my courses, the one called Easy Video for Courses at easyvideoforcourses.com, if you feel like that would be a good fit for your audience, hey, you could sign up for the affiliate program and you could make half. You know, that's pretty cool. So again, check that out if you want, onlinecoursecoach.com/affiliate, and you can sign up or at least check it out. And then lastly, how often do you do this throughout the year? Well, I'm a believer that personally, you know, you should do this. I mean, one or two times, you know, you should have affiliates promoting their stuff to your audience just a few times. I mean, I would think no more than four times a year because you really don't want to oversaturate. You don't want to wear out your audience where you're always selling, right? You want to have it where sometimes it's your courses that you're selling, sometimes it's theirs, and that's fine, but you don't always want to be in sales mode. You know, Gary Vaynerchuk wrote the book, Jab, 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 Right Hook. That's something, you know, in the boxing term, you want to, you know, give, give, give before you ask for the sale. And then as far as being an affiliate for other people and kind of, you know, promoting your courses to their audience, that's really, you know, up to you. If you find enough people in different industries or that have different audiences, I don't know that you have to limit yourself. Now, you don't want to be doing this every week or all the time, but again, the more people you can serve, the more courses you can sell. And that's a pretty cool thing. All right. Well, hey, I could talk about this for a lot longer, but I think that's a good synopsis of joint ventures. The bad, the good, the how to get started. And does it fit for you? Does it fit for your business model? Where are you in the process? I'd love to hear your successes, maybe even some failures. Shoot me an email, jeff@onlinecoursecoach.com. I'd love to hear what's going on and some of your successes or failures there of what maybe not to do. And then lastly, if you feel stuck with creating a course, maybe you haven't created it at all, maybe you're still on the sidelines or it's halfway done, you know, and it's been on the shelf for a year, consider that group coaching program. Again, we started September 18th and I'm only taking up to 10 people. So go to onlinecoursecoach.com/group coaching to learn more and fill out the application. Like I said before, you know, we'll be going through my proven plan to help create your course. We'll be having that customized marketing strategy. And then you'll get access to me and the other group members that are motivated Course Creator. So I know it's going to do a lot of awesome things in your business, in your course. And so I'm excited to get that going. So again, go to onlinecoursecoach.com/group coaching, where you can sign up and apply. All right. Well, that is all for today. I really appreciate all you listening to this. Hey, do me a favor. Share this episode with somebody. So if you're listening to this on your workout or on your way to work, well, if you're driving, please don't share this right now, but hit that share button. Maybe it's through email or social media. Just find one person and say, hey, maybe this could be of help to you. I know I constantly have friends that we're sharing different podcast episodes back and forth from different things. And it's really cool to have them say, hey, Jeff, I know you're interested in this. You really need to check out this episode. And so I do. And it's a lot of fun to have those kind of custom recommendations. All right. Well, that is all for today. Thank you so much for listening to this show. I really, really appreciate it. You know, it's my goal, but I hope this is your goal, where I want to help you to teach many to impact millions.